So this is Ike. He is a staple in the Poconos, about 80 years old, climbing trees like a monkey, and I love him. And I have other fans, not fans, I'm a fan of others, two others here in the Poconos. I'm saying, telling you, he's about 80 years old. He's like 80, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's already 80 or past 80?
No, he's 70 something.
Oh, yeah, so he's almost. And he got a hip operation too. I want to know the name of that doctor. Doing this since probably his 20s, I would think, right? Because he went back to college.
Said it for 53 years. So.
53 years? Yeah. I mean, he's got a PhD in trees and whatever you call it. I mean, PhD? Man.
Harper, yeah.
Some doctors don't have PhD. There's a tree doctor right here. And you never know where he's gonna go, so I need to. To me, he's precious, you know. It's a sweet, bittersweet thing I got for him. Yeah. Oh, uh-oh. Is he tied up?
Yep.
Okay. All right, Ike Olson. He's the one that puts the mushrooms. He shaves. He carves. The trees after he cuts them, carves them into mushrooms. Now he's coloring them in different colors these days. So wherever you see a mushroom, it's actually the remnant of a tree, if I said it correctly. So you see him, he's behind that leaf and he's up on
it. It took me about 15 years to figure out where those mushrooms are coming from.
I know, right? I answer that on Facebook all the time. Who's the, but what are these things? They put a picture, I'm like, I tell the story.
I was a kid, and then when I met my wife, I was trying to find one for our front yard, and none of the lawn shops have them. They don't know what you're talking about.
That's funny.
You gotta go to him for.
You were looking to buy one.
Yeah. And they direct you to like a little flimsy mushroom sign. It's like, no, that's not what I'm talking about. You don't know.
You thought they were popular. I better shut up because he may get nervous. He does get nervous easily. There he goes. On his way to cutting some of my branches, here to rescue me, my hero. Let me get a closer up of him. Almost 80 years old. I thought he was 80 already. He's the hero of the Poconos. He's the one they call in my community when somebody's stuck up in a tree, so he could go up there and rescue them. Can you believe that? When he was well into his 70s, he got called to rescue someone, but he didn't take the call seriously. It was a message. And the guy ended up dying up there on the tree. Young guy, probably half his age, and he was called to rescue him. Can you imagine that? Yeah. Mike Olson. O-L-S-E-N, I think, or O-N.
Your shoe for you.
See the young guys stay at the bottom? They stay at the bottom. He's the one that does the climbing. It's no joke. See, he's the one that does the climbing. So I say he climbs like a monkey. But he is on a rope now. But do I dare do that? I'm afraid of heights. This man's been doing this for 53 years. 53 years. My hero. I think he's everybody's hero. He's not going to be proud of that, huh? He's tough, though. That's why I said earlier, bittersweet. Oh, he'll put you... You know, you better get it straight with him. You don't mess with him. Not with Mike Olson, though. So he's getting rid of all the dead branches. He's chopping them down while he's up there. He's not dizzy. I mean, 53 years doing it. You know, he had to stop probably for about a year. Remember when he was walking with a cane? And I got to get the name of his doctor because that doctor certainly performed a miracle. I think Ike should get disability insurance for his body parts since he does this for a living. And I mean, could have gotten $1 million if he were insured and his hips weren't bad. Then again, based on his age, I'm not too sure they would have insured him, unless he would have bought it when he was much younger. Being in the business 53 years, that could have happened. But look at him. I mean, he's just standing on that, cutting pieces, not afraid, not dizzy, nothing. His workers. My little house, yeah, where is he? I lost him, oh my goodness. Where is he? Oh my goodness, I lost him. Let me see, I think I found him. Yeah, there he is. Don't get it wrong. If his workers get it wrong, he's gonna give him peace of his mind. He won't curse though, I don't think. Never heard him curse. I'm just cutting some branches out for me that are dangerous, that are always falling apart when it rains or there's a storm. So that's gonna clear up a little bit. He's pulling, he's got a rope up there, you see that? And I don't know, I don't know if he's pulling down the branch so it would fall. He's got it all set up there, way above him. Way above him. I was taking a test, but this is more fun. Tell me, come out and film me if you wanna. I want my autograph. Cause he yelled at me earlier. I tried to take a picture. He's like, can I take a picture of you? He says, nope. I said, okay. Ran right inside. You gotta obey the man. For sure. So. Getting ready, baby. Getting ready. Zoom, zoom. Got all those ropes up there. Half a dozen of something he wants. Don't mess with the man. I think he's from Jersey. I dare to yell and ask him, but he'll tell me to shut up. He's got to focus. So he's pulling up like they create a, what do you call it? Sort of like a dumbbell, dumbwaiter kind of thing, I guess. My hands are tied from, I should go get my tripod. But he'll yell at me if I cross him. He doesn't want me underneath him or around him because things are dropping. He's very protective, very responsible. Very much in tune. Love Ike. Who doesn't love, who can't love the man? You know how many mushroom kind of carvings he's left behind as a signature that he's cut their trees? People, did you hear the story? The young man here that works for him said that. His young man said, well, he went to a store to buy a mushroom. But he was really talking about Ike's mushrooms that he carves when he finishes cutting trees. It's not for sale. Not on stores. This was when he was younger and now he's working for the guy. Good thing to work for him. Work for and with him. See, his t-shirt has the name of his company. And this is his truck here. Oops, let me see. This truck right here. This is a sign if anybody wants to do business with him. Just call Ike. There you go. Whenever you see this, you know who's driving the car. There you go. So let me get him back. Let's see, where is he? Inside of him. Yeah, you can hardly see him. There he goes. So he tells him, you gotta listen to me. I told you. That's right. Ike Olson. He says he's gonna live another 40 years. If anybody's gonna live 40 years, it probably would be him. At his age, right? Another 40 years at his age. Like in like almost 120. I think this man will be climbing trees even when he's in his 90s. He's not going anywhere. At least he doesn't plan on it. Mm-mm. No, no, no. Mike Olson, the tree guy. He's been a blessing in my life. When I bought this house, it was a foreclosure. He cut some trees behind my house. Now he's still in the front. This will trim to other trees. Oh. Oh, he told him to pull. I thought it was like something else. Okay. See, he's selling him. Yeah, no, I'm too cold.
Too close to me. Yeah. That's why you get hurt. No, I was fixing my glove. I knew I had to walk that corner.
See, it's all.
Here we go. Pull.
He ties up what's going to go down. There we go. That's him. He's only cutting parts of the tree, and then he's going to tie it up so it won't rock and be all fast. He's not literally cutting the tree, although that is what he does. He's just going to do something that his PhD taught him to do, and most tree guys have no clue that it can be done. It took him about an hour to get set up there, and he ordered me to get inside. And me, like a little puppy, I got inside, quietly. And I started to take a test. Right? I had to take a course. But I zoom through it, Medicare, because it's my third rodeo there. He's gonna start answering some questions. So he recruited me to go out here and show him. Rambo. Rambo. They need to make a movie on him. Imagine if they do, they take this film as a documentary. Imagine that. The Pride of PA, I would say. In my book. Oh, yeah. Dr. Simeon, my chiropractor is another one, and the flag man, Lawrence Chinelisco, something like that. my three Pocono heroes. I am very glad to be in the Poconos for 16 years. It's been a blessing. It's been a ride. Dealing with the cold weather. Don't think I'm ready for the hurricanes. Although I thought I was. So a hurricane happened. And people who wouldn't let me in their house for the winters, well, I don't blame them, right? Well, pitifully, sorry, my condolences is there. Homes got almost destroyed. In need of a lot of repair, and who knows if the insurance covered it down on the Cape. I hope my friend Paige is fine. Her house is getting better, but all of her favorite spots are gone. She actually had a group of friends that were elderly. She would hang out with them and McDonald's. She's a good person. Very similar to me. Something I would do. I call my friend, my best friend, someone who, he's advanced in age, but he's not that advanced. I mean, he's only like 72, 73, maybe 74. And he's my pen pal. Anybody who lives in pen pal still? Well, pray. So they could control where it lands. There you go. See, he's pulling himself up.
I can teach you how to do this.
Can you? My friend. Alignable meeting. This is a historic moment. I'm not gonna miss it for the world. You know, knock on my door. He's like, come out here. Now you can come out. So can't be coming in and out. He said, gotta go by his release. Thank you. Tree is a maple tree, by the way. Except maple trees are slow like molasses in making maple. So, just standing here, my legs hurt. This man is climbing trees. Signals them, I don't understand his language, but I think they do. So even holding this camera is a big job for me, and this man's climbing trees, huh? Gotta love it. Set in his ways, good man. She gets you lunch, dinner, do things for you. He's not even doing think that he does this for a living, for money. I don't think he's loaded or anything, but it's his passion. All I had to do was call him and tell him I needed this.
Is she writing all this down?
I'm filming it.
Film it. I want you to write it down. Tell it.
Write it down?
You want the wood stack somewhere when I finished?
Yeah, but my arm here is, I gotta focus on the arm. Yeah, I mean, you guys are gonna take it? Or?
We're leaving it for you.
Oh, okay.
I thought.
You know what it is? I have a fireplace, but I don't have it installed. I got scammed. I mean, he was really good. He did good work on my chimney, but then he had me prepay and he never came back. Never prepay. Never prepay. Well, I keep losing him. Let's see, where is he? Up there. But I actually have a wood burning stove. Almost connected.
Oh, there you go. I got the wood for it.
By the time I get it connected, it'll probably rot. If I find somebody, we'll see. Never know.
I haven't been to mount my TV on the wall for 3 years now. The mount's still sitting behind the couch. I got the pieces. It's too late to do it.
What a fun job. Let's see. Let me just minimize this. He's way up there. I'm not sure where he's. Oh, wow. He's almost at the top. Wait a minute. He's almost. Where is he? There he is. Let's see if I could get him. He wants me to write it down. He's just teasing. He's a good man. Special man. Special man. We had a falling out. Wow. I mean, I'm here 8 years. I met him before I came here. Like maybe 10 years ago. At a diner, no less. And I'm a pretty talkative person. And where I lived in Effort at the time, boy, I was hungry to talk to people. Gee, I lost him. I don't know where he is. Oh, there he is. That's him. That's him right there. Boom. Cutting some stuff off. I think I love the Poconos. People like this make me love it. They give character to the place. Him? Did he go to the other side now? Where is it? No, no, he's here. He's right up here. Wait a minute. Where is it? You see him over there? Let me see if I can. There we go. There we go. So this is how close he is to the top. It's a big tree. Oh boy, did I lose him? There it is. And he tells him to pull. And you gotta pull. We better pull. He means it when he says it. Don't mess with Ike. Do not mess with me. No! I don't know if he's going to me about falling. I didn't get it.
Oh, I can hear you, though.
Imagine, some people need caretaking at that age. Even diaper change and all. He says he's going to live forever, at least 40 more years. Well, if anybody will do it, he's a strong man. Gone through hip surgeries and all, but survived it, climbing trees again.
Cut it up and leave right there.
Yep, 60-year-olds that can't even walk down the block. See, he's getting higher. He's almost at the top. You see that? Almost at the top. Boom. God be with him. In Jesus' name, protect him and his staff always. It's a labor of love. Not even my 40-year-old wood stove guy who did my chimney and scammed me. Thin guy, just like Ike. He actually fell off the tree. Doesn't want to go back to work either. He's done. He wants to resell stuff. You got Ike, almost 80 years old. He's not going nowhere. I purposely said it in poor English grammar. He's not going anywhere. So let me see. Yeah, he's hitting behind the leaves. That's what I want to say. He's on. I don't know where he's at now. Where is he? There he is.
There you go. What? I need that pole saw.
Pole saw. Yeah.
Pole clip.
Pole clip or pole saw?
Pole clip.
Pole clip.
Pole clip. Coming right up. So I don't know how he's going to get it to him. He's gonna clip it. Where is he? Wait a minute. I'm losing him. Where is he? I do it from here. Yeah, there we go. There he is. I'm on my neighbor's driveway now. Once you get him to pull clip, see how he's very close to the top? You see that? He loves it done fast. I don't blame him. He'd be crapping in my pants by now. So they transport things to him. See that? You see that stick? Somehow that stick arrived from the bottom, and they kind of like seesaw things down to each other. Troublemaker Tesla behind me. He's making a U-turn. Making nosy guy. See, coming to make a U-turn. Because he's nosy. Glad he's going to court. Put and guns on people's heads for no reason. Baze comes back. He wants to take a look at who is here. He knows it already. He's right behind me right now. But a freaking troublemaker, that man. Or even just to be nosy. He just wants to take a look at me because he wants to know who's Annette's friend. Doesn't like anybody talking about him. He knows she's telling people the truth about him. Driving around, seeing who could look for trouble with. His community's taking him to court, thank God. He seems tired. God help him, be with him always. Touch his heart, Lord. He may come closer to you in Jesus' name. Oh, he's way up in the top. Oh my goodness, look at that. He's way at the top. You see that? Let's see if I could bring it closer. There he goes. Works best when you keep yourself slim, not too heavy for those branches, that's for sure.
Pull through on the ridge.
Hold on.
No! Go through!
See, so they got like a dumbwaiter going on, elevator kind of thing. Giving him the things he needs up there. So that's what they do. That's, everybody does it different. He sets up a dumb waiter kind of system. I don't even know that he's got spikes on his shoes, but if he does, it's probably toward the inside. Tell me this isn't how it works. This man thrives doing it.
Through if you can.
See, they gotta know his tech language.
Okay. Okay. One of you on the red rope, one on the blue rope.
Okay. One on the red rope. That doesn't look like a red rope to me, but I guess it is.
See, no,
just
blue over here. Right up.
Okay, I didn't make a knot.
So he's gonna make a knot. It's like a timber or another branch. I mean, it's really three trees in one. And he's just gonna wrap one up to the other two, so they wouldn't be, the tree won't be weighed down toward the side, so it won't fall.
Pull that!
Ike, I'm trying to get over this nub.
Well, you're pulling me in the process.
Well, it's all tangled up with your rope down there.
Don't worry about that yet.
There you go, see?
That nub right there.
Now, switch them around. Put the red rope on the right, on the other side. Okay, let me notch it now.
Ike, the blue rope is tangled up with your rope right there with that little notch down there. That's why I'm trying to get the blue rope off of it, off that nub. See what I'm talking about?
Where is Ike Olson? Because I'm trying to figure out what they're talking about.
Nothing you can do about it anyway.
You want me to move, to get in and move it?
No problem. Let me notch it.
I got it. Okay. You just gotta move your one climbing rope, though.
Don't pull it till I tell you now.
Your one climbing rope is tied up with that one.
Don't worry about it. Yeah.
He's good. He says, don't worry about it. Yeah. Deer are coming, and we don't want that. Deers are coming. I'm gonna go. I'll go get the deer. Because they may get interfered with the work. The deer. Over here. Come over here, deer. Robbie. Over here. Okay, they're eating the leaves from the tree. Seems like the tree is a treat to them, huh? Huh. They like the leaves of the tree. Look at that. It's a treat to them. They could never reach them. They're enjoying that, sucker. Okay, you're in a safe place. Oh, let me go back to my little spot here. Because he is all the way. Let me show you the whole tree, okay? He's all the way up here. So he's tying up the rope, and when he tells them to pull, they pull it in a safe direction. Like there's a seat up there. This man is up there for hours and he's not exactly sitting down. Not exactly sitting down, is he? Most people 10, 15 years younger than him are sitting in a recliner all day long. To where I could see him. The sun is in my eyes. I'm not sure I can see where he's at. I can only see my reflection. Oh my goodness. Where is he? Oh, the sun. I can't really see him. Gotta be up there somewhere, but the sun. Let me go to where there's a shade. Oh, okay. Let me go to the other direction.
Oh, what?
This direction. Yeah. Ooh. Not sure I can see him. Well, it's a glare, that's for sure. Set him. There he is. Boom. See how close he is to the top? Uh-oh, so listen again. There he is. Protect everybody, protect him always on his job, but this now will survive all the risks that he takes. Who knows what he's doing, but his workers would always sink with him in Jesus' name. And following orders, there we go, timber, almost timber, almost timber time. Boom. Big piece. Ooh. There you go. Boom. There you go. Down. Everybody's safe. Looks good. Bugs are eating me. I'm on the grass now. Ooh, I should have put some peppermint oil. Oh my goodness, because oh my god, we gotta be careful with the deer ticks too. My dear. My dear, but I don't love the deer tags. Not what they wear in their fine coats. Am I itching like crazy? I don't have a deer coat or something. Where did he go? Where did I go? Ooh, my feet in the grass. Where is he? Oh boy, I don't know where he is. Can anybody spot him? Should wear a neon cap or whatever you call that thing. So he's busy tying up the next branch, and then he'll tell them to pull, and when they're ready to pull, he'll cut. I get the gist already. I'm itching. I hope I'm climbing my legs. I mean, let's see. Whoa. Awesome. I'm scratching my leg. There he is. See some movement there.
Hey, look.
boom.
You write that down, Risha.
Shut it down? You're way at the top, man.
This is my world.
That's your world. That's
my
right.
World.
Let me see. I lost you on the camera. Where are you? Oh, God. It's your world up there, right? Being at the top. I lost him. Where is he? Where is he? I don't know where he is.